I shall largely speak of mice. But my thoughts are on man. On healing. On life. And its evolution. There have been experiments done by John B. Calhoun on mice that showed that overcrowding reduces fertility. In the early 1960s, Calhoun created his most famous experiment, the mouse universe. The universe was a 9-foot square metal pen with 4.5-foot sides. There was no shortage of food or water or nesting material. There were no predators. The only adversity was the limit on space. 4 pairs of mice were introduced into the utopian universe. Initially, the population grew rapidly, doubling every 55 days. The population reached 620 by day 315, after which the population growth dropped markedly, doubling only every 145 days. The last surviving birth was on day 600, bringing the total population to a mere 2,200 mice. Even though the experiment setup allowed for double that number in terms of nesting space. This period between day 315 and day 600 saw a breakdown in social structure and in normal social behavior. After day 600, the social breakdown continued and the population declined toward extinction. During this period, females ceased to reproduce. Their male counterparts withdrew completely, never engaging in courtship or fighting. These last mice were dubbed the beautiful ones by Calhoun. Due to a lack of scar tissue and sleek healthy coats from self-grooming. Breeding never resumed and behavior patterns were permanently changed. Even when the population dropped to a low level, the mice did not resume breeding. The conclusions drawn from this experiment were that when the overcrowding is high enough, competition and the stresses experienced by the individuals will result in a total breakdown in complex social behaviors, ultimately resulting in the demise of the population. Calhoun saw the fate of the population of mice as a metaphor for the potential fate of man. His study has been cited by writers such as Bill Perkins as a warning of the dangers of living in an increasingly crowded and impersonal world. Calhoun wrote his findings in an essay he titled Death Squared. In it he wrote, "For an animal so simple as a mouse, the most complex behaviors involve the interrelated set of courtship, maternal care, territorial defense and hierarchical intergroup and intergroup social organization. When behaviors related to these functions fail to mature, there is no development of social organization and no reproduction. As in the case of my study reported above, all members of the population will age and eventually die. For an animal so complex as man, there is no logical reason why a comparable sequence of events should not also lead to species extinction." There were also experiments done by Jonathan Friedman. By putting humans under high-density conditions to monitor their behavior. However, they were not long enough to see any visible changes. We need to put people into high-density environments for generations, as was the case with the mice. But in fact, we had already done that. People in many countries have now been living in highly urbanized cities for multiple generations, and we are already seeing the birth rates drop significantly. And the urbanization rate is increasing all the time, with the majority of the world population expected to live in urban areas in the near future. The world urbanization rate has increased from 33% in 1960 to 56% in 2020. It can also be seen that in most countries with high urbanization rates throughout the world today, such as in Europe and East Asia, that the fertility is sub-replacement. Young people in these countries, such as the millennial and Gen Z generations, are having greatly reduced fertility as well when compared to the older generations, such as the baby boomers. In Japan, these youth are called herbivore men, in China they are called bare branches, in the West they are called encelibates. Young men who have lost interest or been rejected by the opposite sex. These characteristics are similar to the non-reproducing socially withdrawn, beautiful ones, mice near the end of the experiment. And as youth increasingly continue to shun parenthood, this trend will only persist and get worse in the future. Currently, around 50% of the world already live in sub-replacement fertility countries. By the end of the century, the UN predicts that only a handful of countries will have replacement fertility. If the trend persists, the human race will go extinct like the mouse utopian population. Once a population starts to decline from sub-replacement fertility, it is impossible to stop the decline without immigration. And even immigration is a temporary solution, as the immigrants will also copy the habits of the host population. Eventually, a population with sub-replacement fertility will disappear. However, this is nothing new. Ancient civilizations on Earth had people living in high-density cities for thousands of years. To understand the future of humanity, we must look deeper into the past and find out what happened to all of the ancient civilizations. As we can see from history, there are very many examples of great civilizations that have collapsed. The collapse of various civilizations such as the Roman Empire, the Greek Empire, the Mycenaeans, Assyrians, Hittites, Indus Valley, the Minoans, ancient Egypt, the Sumerians, Mayans, and many others will be explained. The Roman Empire is usually the most studied ancient civilization that has collapsed. One of the causes is that the capital city of ancient Rome, which had a population of about 1.5 million during the reign of Trajan in the early 2nd century, declined to only 15,000 inhabitants by the 4th century. The population declined by more than 99% in the space of a few centuries. However, even though the population decline was documented, the question is, why did the population decline? The Roman Empire had very high urbanization rates that were not seen in Europe until after at least the 19th century, and evidently many Romans had spent much time in cities for their fertility to decline to very low levels. In a speech to Roman nobles, the Emperor Augustus commented on the low birth rates of the Roman elite. How otherwise can families continue? How can the state be preserved, if we neither marry nor have children? For surely you are not expecting men to spring up from the ground to succeed you, as the myths describe. And yet it is neither right nor creditable that our race should cease, and the name of Romans be blotted out with us, and the city be given over to foreigners. Greeks or even barbarians. Do we not free our slaves chiefly for the express purpose of making out of them as many citizens as possible? And do we not give our allies a share in the government in order that our numbers may increase? And do you, then, who are Romans from the beginning and claim as your ancestors the famous Fabii, the Quintii, and the Julii, do you desire that your families and names alike shall perish with you? The Greek historian Polybius also largely blamed the decline of the Hellenic world on low fertility rates. Writing in his work, The Histories, that in our time all Greece was visited by a dearth of children and generally a decay of population, owing to which the cities were denuded of inhabitants, and a failure of productiveness resulted, though there were no long continued wars or serious pestilences among us, for this evil grew upon us rapidly and without attracting attention. By our men becoming perverted to a passion for show and money and the pleasures of an idle life, and accordingly either not marrying at all, or if they did marry, refusing to rear the children that were born or at most one or two out of a great number, for the sake of leaving them well off, or for bringing them up in extravagant luxury. Human civilization inevitably leads to greater levels of urbanization. Past civilizations have all succumbed to sub-replacement fertility due to high urbanization rates. The textbook collapse of the major Roman and Greek civilizations can be seen again in the Late Bronze Age collapse. The Mayan collapse and other collapses. All of these civilizations shared the same fate in the end. The rapid decline of population. The abandonment of cities. The invasions by barbarians. It can all be attributed to sub-replacement fertility which the Roman and Greek historians have told us about, and which we are seeing in the world today. Since no past civilization on Earth has been able to survive sub-replacement fertility due to low fertility from high urbanization rates, we can see that the contemporary solutions available to us have very low chances of success. Even an all-powerful emperor like Augustus could not raise the ancient Roman fertility rates. Even though he enacted powerful laws with benefits for the people who had children and massive penalties on the childless, all his efforts proved to have been in vain. The same attempts in democracies are even less likely to work. We can already see the various financial pronatalist policies enacted by governments largely failing to raise fertility above replacement. The only way to preserve civilization for the long term is with new solutions. There is the possibility of artificial wombs, such as in the Matrix where humans are grown. However, we are far away from that technologically. There is the possibility of creating an artificial intelligence. However, again, we are very far away from that technologically. There is also the possibility of genetic engineering, which could somehow reverse aging or make humans immune to the effects of urban living. Humanity has evolved in a low-density environment, living in small tribes for millions of years. It is only recently that people have started living in cities with huge numbers of people. However, we are not biologically prepared for living with such large numbers of people. The only way to survive is to take evolution into our own hands. Since Calhoun lived in an age before genetic engineering, he would not have been able to do any experiments on the mice. to see if tweaking their DNA would help them survive the mouse utopia. He tried all other options to try to increase the survival time of the mice by rationing food, space, and other factors, but nothing worked. However, since we have genetic engineering technology available to use now, we should now try to use genetic engineering on mice to see if we can increase their survival time in a high-density environment and restart Calhoun's experiments. Check the description for links where all of this information was gathered from.